A new 3D printer with a very familiar design boasts many cool features at an affordable price tag. But there's a catch, and I've got the full story right here on 3D Printing Nerd. This is a new machine from LotMax called the SC10 Shark. Their goal with this machine is to produce something affordable that can print fast, print well, and give the user options such as dual extrusion or a laser engraver attachment. When I received the machine, it was packed extremely well and getting it out of the box was no problem at all. Setup was simple and I was up and running rather quickly. The specs on this machine are pretty decent. 260C max on the nozzle, and that's because it's PTFE straight down to the 0.4 millimeter nozzle, which means PLA, ABS, PETG, and TPU are all within your temperature range. 100C max on the bed with a custom surface on flexible steel. Build dimensions, 235 on the X, 235 on the Y, and 265 on the Z or Z. It's got filament runout detection. It's got a dual gear extruder. It means it grips the filaments on two sides as it's moving it. There is a Meanwell power supply in this thing, and that's a 3.5 inch TFT touchscreen on a cable that reminds me of my old ColecoVision.
ColecoVision? Sorry, Atari.
It's powered by a 32-bit board with TMC 2208 drivers, meaning it's quiet. There's belt tensioners on X and Y, and four, count them, four fans on the hot end, one on the heat sink, and three blowing down to cool the filament. See, we'll get shots of all that.
Yeah.
Out of the box, prints were okay. I was using some red PLA that was included with the machine, and it was giving decent results. However, switching over to the orange PLA they included with the machine gave better results. The machine can print pretty quick, and it does this in two ways. There is a speed setting on the touchscreen, and that can be changed at any time. Users can also use profiles in the slicer to select faster speeds. The normal print speed is set at 60 millimeters per second. A middle print speed is available at 90 millimeters per second, and the fast is 135 millimeters per second. Faster speeds don't work for all models and all geometries, so it's up to the user to experiment. In my initial tests, a 20 millimeter cube was most accurate when printed at normal speed. An on-screen guide helps you level the bed with some paper and adjustment knobs in all four corners. Filament detection works, and I had no problems switching filaments. The extruder was able to push filaments consistently, and I could view the screen at any angle because it's just not attached to the machine. Again, ColecoVision. The SC10 Shark also has optional additions, such as an auto leveling probe, the ability to print with two colors, and even a laser engraver. Auto leveling is via a probe they call a 3D touch, and probing is done on a 3x3 grid on the bed. The touch screen allows you to set an offset for the probe. Dual color is accomplished with an additional extruder and a new hot end. The additional extruder is the same as the first, meaning it has dual gears and a filament runout detection sensor. Cables attach to the front of the machine, and the new hot end is a direct replacement. You just swap it out, and it utilizes a Y splitter at the top, allowing two filaments to share the same pathway to the nozzle. Installing the new hot end requires removing the heater cartridge and the thermistor, and that's from the original block, and you attach it to the new block. I know, this can be tricky, but if you're careful, most of you won't have an issue. Configuring dual color is done through the LotMax slicer, and you'll want to customize settings depending on the filament that you choose. Filaments with more pigment require more purge, else you end up with mixed colors. The laser engraver bracket attaches to the same point that the auto level bracket attaches to, and the control blocks plugs right into the front of the printer. Focal length for the laser is set by setting the Z height and then by rotating the laser head. Once your focal length is set correctly, the user uses the laser section of the slicer to create the G code of whatever you want the laser to engrave. Also, be sure to be safe. Wear the included safety glasses and only operate this in an area with adequate ventilation and/or a fume extractor. I had mixed results with the laser, and it was very much because of my inexperience, and I'm pretty sure I could get better results with some more practice, because practice makes perfect. The SC10 Shark, it's priced at $249 USD, Adding the dual color is a $30 upgrade. Adding the auto level is a $20 upgrade. And adding the laser engraver, that'll cost you $80. In a nutshell, that is the LotMax SC10 Shark. Wait, there's a catch. Initially, I was sent this machine to provide a review. After some emails back and forth, the words I usually dread were written. Crowdfunding. As I was using the machine for review, I was taking notes on the problems I had found, since that's the sort of thing I would mention during the review process. Crowdfunding changes things. The machine isn't going to be the machine that backers get, and the problems I'm facing will most likely have a chance to be fixed before the machine gets released. There's time to get testing done and get fixes in place. LotMax mentions to me they want to use my review to help launch the Kickstarter for this machine. I have a conversation with the team at LotMax as I'm concerned with this entire situation. I mention my review experience so far and how I have this list of problems that will need to be talked about during the review video. LotMax wrote back saying, "We have no problem with that, but can you let us know the problems so that maybe we can fix them?" At this point, I have an idea. Listen, I was a test engineer for more than 20 years. A person whose job it is to break hardware and software, write reports on the breaks, and then send that to developers who would then fix problems based on my reports, making the products or services better for the end user. I knew what I had to do. I talked to my contacts at LotMax, Alina and Luke, and they liked the plan. They hired me for a short time to test their printer, send them bug reports, test fixes, and produce a video about the machine. I'm contributing to a low-cost machine, and I'm helping make it better. I've received numerous firmware drops and slicer fixes in this time of use, and it's resulted in a much better user experience. I've given them guidance on what people will look for and what a typical user will want to see. I've given specific reports on functionality that was needed and what hardware changes would be best. The firmware now has added functionality and the user interface has more options, and the hardware side benefited from my suggestions. Even now, a cable clamp model I suggested will ship on the SD card with every machine for anyone to print as many as they want to at home. Yes, I do advise to only invest in a Kickstarter with money you can afford to set on fire. That's never gonna change. However, what's changing is the way companies are approaching their crowdfunding campaigns. A company not using a reviewer as a beta tester is awesome. I'm excited to be a part of this positive progress. And if you choose to back this machine, I hope my efforts have made its use a more enjoyable experience. And listen, if you've made it this far, you're awesome. All the information you might need is down in the description below. Be safe, be awesome. Don't forget to hug each other more. And as always, high five.